नमस्ते। सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमास्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरुपरंपरा श्रुतिश्रुतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बाजराजनं सूत्रभाष्यकृत वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौनक्तु सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रविणोति तस्मै तवं हृदयमात्मनि प्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्गणगणेशमनोभूयं सुखनित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपाधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्या बोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्तु निर्मलं पारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महा तदेवान्नमत्तु स्थामतिः। सो अष्टादश विद्याया प्रस्थानानि। देयर आर 18 विद्यास टॉक्ड अबाउट। व्हाट आर दोस? सो तर्क दृष्टि इज लुकिंग एट दीज। वेदाश्चत्वारः उपवेदाश्चत्वारः वेदांगानि षट्। सो यू हैव फोर वेदास, फोर उपवेदास एंड सिक्स वेदांगास। पुराणानि पुराण न्याय मीमांसा धर्मशास्त्राणि चत्वारि च इत्येवं वैखरी वाणी संस्कृत भाषा रूपा अष्टादश भेदा भवति। सो देयर इज दिस वैखरी वाणी। वेदाज विच आर एक्सप्रेस्ड इन वर्ड फॉर्म, मैनिफेस्ट वर्ड फॉर्म वैखरी, दैट वाणी इज संस्कृत भाषा रूपा। इट्स दैट्स व्हाई वी कॉल इट एज देवनागरी भाषा। सम्यक्कृतम्, सम्यक्कृतम् इज संस्कृतम्। सो इवन इन प्रॉपर उच्चारण ऑफ संस्कृत देयर इज पुण्य, दैट इज ए सम्यक्ता इन संस्कृतम्। अष्टादश प्रस्थानानि इति ते एव भेदा उच्यन्ते। दीज आर दी 18 प्रस्थानास्। सो नाउ तर्कदृष्टि इन्क्वायर्स इनटू दी वास्ट नॉलेज दैट इज अवेलेबल इन संस्कृत भाषा दी वैखरी वाणी विच हैज ऑल कम फ्रॉम ईश्वर एंड देन देयर आर डेरिवेटिव्स देयर ऑफ। सो चतुर्णापि वेदानां ब्रह्मज्ञान एव ब्रह्मज्ञाने एव तात्पर्यम्। तात्पर्य द कल्मिनेशन ऑफ ऑल द फोर वेदास इज इन ब्रह्मज्ञान अलोन, नथिंग एल्स। सो ऋग्वेद यजुर्वेद सामवेद अथर्ववेद इति वेदाश्चत्वारः। वी नो दिस, सो आई एम गोइंग टू स्पीड थ्रू दिस सेक्शन। कानिचित् वाक्यानि ज्ञेय ब्रह्मबोधकानि, कानिचित् ध्येय ब्रह्मबोधकानि, इतराणि तु कर्मबोधकानि। सो दीस four vedas all have sections. Some parts are upanishad where they are committed to revealing the brahma. Which brahma? That brahma which is jnatum yogya. So jnatum yogya brahma bodhakani vakyani. Then others are committed to upasana, therefore dhyeya brahma bodhakani, whereas most of the part is related to karma, ritualistic karma kanda, so karma bodhakani itarani. Karma bodhaka veda vachananam api antakkarana shuddhi dvara jnanam eva prayojanam bhavati. We have seen earlier this ध्येय ब्रह्म बोधक वाक्यास आर कमिटेड टू उपासनास एंड थ्रू उपासनास दे मेक दी माइंड स्थिर, अंतकरण स्थिर एंड गिव योग्यता फॉर ज्ञेय ब्रह्म अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस ज्ञेय ब्रह्म बोधक वाक्यास। कर्म प्रिपेयर्स द पर्सन इवन फॉर एकाग्रता बाय ब्रिंगिंग इन चित्त शुद्धि। Therefore, karma bodhaka vakyas are also committed towards the same thing. Kasyapi vedavachanasya na pravrtta avipraya. Any veda vakya, puramimamsaka will interpret based on lot of textual evidence across the Vedas. Across the Vedas, across sections, but the textual analysis, Mimamsa, which is called as Mimamsa, that will lead to a particular meaning. Then using Lakshana, if necessary, one arrives at the complete understanding of the Vakya. Whenever any Lakara is seen, each Lakara has a particular grammatical meaning. However, almost all Lakaras in Vedas, for example, late Lakara, we don't have Adhikara in, only Vedas have Adhikara in. Late Lakara has the same meaning of whittling. Lot has the same meaning of whittling. Kritya Pratyas have the same meaning of whittling. So, Tavya, Tavya, Aniyara. These are all having the same meaning of whittling. Lot, late have the meaning of whittling. Lat is Vartamane. Vartamane, Lat. However, if you see Lat Lakara in Vedas, Karmakandi says that Lat Lakara is also Vidhi Rupa, therefore it is interpreted as Vidhiling. However, Vedanti, who has understood everything, he thinks here, Tattva Drishti, Tarka Drishti here, Kasyapi Vedavachanasya na Pravruttav Abhiprayaha. When a Vidhi is given, then it should be done. This is what Karmakandi tells us. However, Pravruttav Abhipraya Nasti. Lat is interpreted as vidhiling, but Vedanti says that vidhiling, lot, late prayoga itself does not have a vidhi sense, meaning there is nothing in the Vedas that tells you should do it, because you are Atma. Now the person who does not know this, he is asked to do certain things so that you have Chitta Shuddhi and know that you are Atma, where no Niyamas are possible, no Vidhi is possible. So concessionally we say it is Vidhi for Chitta Shuddhi. But if you look at it, there is a Phala associated with it, and Prayojanam Anuddishya Mandopina Pravartate. Without looking, Karmakandi himself says that there has to be a phala. Why? Veda Vakya cannot be meaningless. We say all the Veda Vakyas have meaning in Chitta Shuddhi, Karmakanda, Upasana Ichyadi. But they say no particular phala is mentioned, that is the phala. Even if it is taken as a vidhi, what is the vidhi there? If you want that phala, then you do this. So wanting the phala is Svabhavika. That you should want a phala is not a vidhi. Which part is vidhi? Concessionally, only that part is vidhi, which will tell you have pravritti in this, not as a pravritti really, to take away your pravritti elsewhere. To take away pravritti from nishiddha karma, it tells you do this. That is also svabhavika. Ragadvesha is svabhavika. So svabhavika pravritti is there for phala. To take away that, Shruti says you do this. So it is not really telling you to do this, it is asking you to withdraw from something else. This is true in all vakyas. This is not how Puramimamsaka says, but this is the interpretation of the Vedantin who has understood the Tatparya Vishaya. And towards that Tatparya Vishaya, everything in the Veda is tuned. So the interpretation is in this manner. Kasyapi Veda Vachanasya na Pravruttav Abhiprayaha Kintu Svabhavika Nishiddha Karma Pravruttir Nirodha Eva Abhiprayaha. Even Pratyavaya Dosha that we have seen earlier, Pratyavaya Dosha does not accrue positively, does not come up positively as some new papa which is earned, but on not doing any karma, not doing Nitya Naimittika Karma attracts a Pratyavaya Dosha. We say yes, but it is not a new papa. The earlier papa is not blocked by the Nitya Naimittika Karma because you are not doing Nitya Naimittika Karma. So Pratyavaya Dosha is that dosha where the earlier papas is not blocked, you have not having kavacha, and then it acts out, it gives results. Other way to look at pratyavaya dosha is also the new papa which is earned by giving, not giving up the nityanaimittika karma, but by doing something else when you are supposed to do nityanaimittika karma. So nityanaimittika karma has to be done n number of times during the day. So nitya karma, not naimittika really, but you take nitya karma as an example, it has to be done n number of times during the day. It can be once, twice, thrice, whatever it is, based on sampradaya, and then it should be done only during that time, again based on sampradaya. Udite juhoti or anudite juhoti, there are both sampradayas. One should do prata, sandhya and homa before sunrise or after sunrise. Both niyamas are there based on sampradaya. Both interpretations are there rather. So if a person who follows a particular sampradaya says that it has to be done at this time, then at that time t, if one is not doing that and doing something else, then that will accrue new papa. That is also seen as pratyavaya. So here what is said, kintu swabhavika nishiddha karma pravrutter nirodha eva abhipraya. So this shruti says that instead of whiling your time away and doing something which will give you papa, why don't you do this? So doing this is not a vidhi. Vidhitaya, it is nisheda rupa. It shows as a vidhi, but hidden there is a nisheda. You don't do anything else which will give you papa, because swabhavika indulgence is such. Tasmat abhicharadi karma pratipadaka atharva vedasyapi nivruttaviva tatparyam. Generally atharva veda is kept separately because there are a lot of, you know, these magical spells, you know, some mula for tantra. There are quite a few you know, distasteful kind of karma mentioned in Atharvaveda. Of course, there is lot of good also. Atharvaveda is, you know, kind of ceasing to be in existence. There are very few who know the karma through and through, what has to be done. So sarpa vidya ityadi are there in Atharvaveda. Even it is said that, you know, particular sarpa has bitten you. There are some mantra chants whereby the same sarpa will come back and take away the poison. So such things are talked about Atharva Veda. Now in some sampradayas, like in Havyaka or in, I think, Kota Brahmanas, there is an Achamana Vidhi which is different from others. So you don't have Namas, Keshava Namas. There is Rigveda Swa, Yajurveda Swa, Samaveda Swa. But Atharva Veda Namaha. Atharva Swaha isn't there. So Atharva Veda, in various places you see only three Vedas are talked about. One way to look at it is that the Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda have some specific types of mantras. Atharvaveda has a mix of all. Therefore, Atharvaveda is included in the Vedatraya. And some places it is said that Atharvaveda is not regularly followed. It is followed only when you need to fix something. Therefore, something done wrongly or something which has come about by the earlier three Vedas and there is no fix there, that fix is seen in Atharva Veda. So it is brought in only when you need to fix something. That is also one way Atharva Veda is seen. So this background, just to say that such karmas do exist in Atharva Veda, which can be seen as Himsatmaka also. But in Vedas, there is no Himsa really. Ahimsa should be followed except when Veda tells you that you do this. Because there is a little Himsa in the Vedas whereby greater Himsa is avoided. So you have to see it that way. For example, there are a lot of people, you may have also come across, as to Gita. In Gita, Krishna says that you fight the war. Whereas Arjuna is not interested. So there are many Aropa saying that Krishna asked a person to perform violent karmas. But no one understands that there is a greater good in that, because adharma will take over if such himsa is not done. So in war it is applicable. There is no crime there in killing the enemy. If the enemy is going to bring more adharma. Now that is the Dharma Shastra rule. With that background, you have to see this as to what kind of karmas are there and are they really vidhis or they are nishedas. This is the inquiry that Tarkadrishti has done. He says, Kintu swabhavika nishiddha karma pravrutte he nirodha eva abhiprayaha. Tasmad avicharadi karma pratipadaka atharva vedasya api nivruttaveva tatparyam shatru samhartavya iti dvesha vashad yo garadaneva अग्निदाहे वा प्रवर्तते तम शत्रु मारण प्रवृत्ते हे व्यावर्तयितुम अभिचार कर्म रूपाः शेन यागादयः कथिता. शेन यागा इज वेयर अ पर्सन डज अ यागा टू किल द एनिमी, डज नॉट फिजिकली किल द एनिमी बाय गोइंग देयर बट यूजेस अलौकिक उपाय. नाउ दिस इज अ निषेध. इट इज नॉट सेइंग दैट यू डू दिस कर्म एंड किल द एनिमी. इट इज सेइंग दैट इफ यू वांट टू किल द एनिमी, do not go around and poison or burn his palace, whatever, you know, burn that person's house. Don't do that, because that is sakshat krura karma. Here you are invoking the grace and saying that may that person's karma prarabdha be put to an end. So that is how you have to read into it. So shena yaga is done by, there is no sakshat krura karma there. There is, you are asking someone else to take care of your problem. You are praying that such a problem gets resolved, and then thereby you are trying to have sort of a control over your krodha. You don't act out that krodha. You do it away in the homa itself. You put it out in the fire. Whether or not it leads to that result is a different matter. It will lead to the result if it is done properly, but then there will also be papa karma which will accrue here. In comparison though, this person has not acted out, therefore it will not have such an impact on the society as it would be having if he had actually gone ahead and done the sakshat karma, krura karma. So shatru should be taken care of anyway. So you don't go and kill him by poisoning, etc., which will accrue more papa immediately. However, you go ahead and do the shena yaga. Therefore, shena yaga is not a vidhi, but withdrawal from poisoning or burning the enemy is the nisheda there. And this is extended to each and every part of the shastra by prathama malla nyaya. शत्रु संहारे निमित्त भूतम कर्म अभिचार इत्युच्यते. सो अभिचार इज दैट कर्म वेयर यू वांट टू टेक केयर. सो टू से यू नो द फ्रेज इज क्वाइट फेमस, टेक केयर ऑफ द एनिमी. ईदृशं कर्म शेन याग इत्युच्यते. शेन याग कर्तव्यता बोधक वेदवचनानामपि शत्रुवद कामः शेनेन शेनेन अभिचरन् यजेत. सो शत्रुवद कामः shenena abhicharam yajeta. It is not saying you do this. What is it saying? A person who is shatru vada kamaha. That kama is making you act out. What is that kama? Wanting to kill the enemy. So shatru vada kamaha yaha saha yajeta. How? Shenena abhicharam. So he should withdraw from the शत्रु वधा कर्म एंड इंस्टेड डू शेन यागा. दैट इज व्हाट इज सेड. सो विड्रॉवल फ्रॉम शत्रु वधा इज व्हाट इज निषिद्ध देयर. दैट इज द निषेध बीइंग डन. इत्यादि नाम शेन याग प्रवृत्तौ न तात्पर्यम् किंतु शत्रु मारण कामस्य शेन यागादि विलक्षण विषदानादि शत्रु मारण उपायांतर निवृत्तौ एव तात्पर्यम्. So it is nisheda rupa pravruttehe dveshata eva praptatvat. Because if there is dvesha, this pravrutti will be there. This dvesha is taken away by saying that you do shena yaga. Now there is a long tippana I'll just mention this. I'll not go through each and every detail. So how many shakas are there? What these shakas contain? That is mentioned there. So in Rigveda, there are 22 shakas. Yajurveda has 108. Samaveda 1000. Atharvaveda 50. In total, there are 1180 shakas. So each shaka has an Upanishad also. So thereby, yatha kashchana vrikshaswami yajmana saputre viha. So etc. How they are divided, all that is mentioned there. So Bhagavan Vyasa divided into four Upanishad, four Vedas, and then shakas also, because the memory for all Vedas wasn't there, it was receding. Therefore, based on the Yuga, based on the Kala, he divided the Vedas. You see, at least you study one Veda, then at least one shakha, swashakha. Even that is no longer possible for many. So people learn some parts, even that is not studied by all. So at least take Gayatri Mantra Upadesha, do that. That also many people don't do. So anyway, there is such division. But what is the importance here? Yavatya Shakha Tavatya Upanishad Iti Muktika Upanishadi Mahavakya Ratnavalyancha Kathyate. Muktika Upanishad, which is the 108th Upanishad, tells, reveals the other Upanishads there, Shanti Mantras, etc. So it says that there are as many Upanishads as there are Shakhas. However, they are lupta in time. Many aren't available. So here, the total there are 1180 Upanishads. In those 840 Upanishads are what? Karma Pratipadakatvat Karma Kanda Uchyante. They are said to be Karma Kanda, Shakhas. Why? Because mostly they are focused on karma. Then the Shakhas, which are Dheya Brahma Bodhaka, which are focused towards Upasanas, there are 232. 108 Upanishads, 108 Shakhas are mostly dealing with the Jneya Brahma. So the 108 shakas are dealing with what? Jneya Brahma. So Jneya Brahma Bodhakatvat Vedasya Antya Bhagatvat Veda Sararta Bodhakatvatcha Vedantaha. This is how Vedantas are discussed. However, there are as many Upanishads as there are shakas. This is one way it is interpreted by the Tippanakara Swamiji. Jnana Kanda Upanishad iti cha uchyante tatrapi Ashtottara Shatopanishad swapi. So in the Ashtottara Shatopanishad also, 100 Upanishads also, the process to understand is through Mandukya first, we have seen earlier. Otherwise the 10 Upanishads, otherwise you go through others, study others for moksha. Here specifically Swamiji says, Ishakena Kata Prashna Munda Mandukya Tittirihi Aitareyancha Chandogyam Brihadaranyakam Tatha. So the Muktika Upanishad mantra says Tatha. It is quoted as Dasha here. There are 10 of these. And the sequence is given in this very sequence. Bhagavan Bhashyakara wrote Bhashyas, Isha Kena Kata Prashna Munda Mandukya Tittiri. Tittiri is Taittiriya Upanishad. Then Aitareya Vino, Chandogya and Brihadaranyaka. These are 10 Upanishads. What are otherwise called by Westerners as primary Upanishads, which is seen here as Mukhyaha. Iti Dasha Upanishadha Mukhyaha. Tatra Aitariya Upanishad Rigveda Gata Isha Brihadaranyake Shukla Yajurveda Gate. So Aitariya is in Rigveda. Isha and Ishavasya Upanishad and Brihadaranyaka are in Shukla Yajurveda. Katavalli Taittariya Krishna Yajurveda Gate. In Krishna Yajurveda you have Kata Upanishad and also called as Katavalli and Taittariya Upanishad. Kena Upanishad and Chandogya are in Samaveda. So Kena Chandogya Samaveda Gate. Prashna Mundaka Mandukya Upanishadaha Atharva Veda Gataha Iti Vivaha. Whereas Prashna Upanishad, Mundaka Upanishad and Mandukya Upanishad are in Atharva Veda. Now all this is mentioned because the focus is on same Tatparya Vishaya. For all Upanishads also and all others also Kramena. All Veda Vakyas. So with that in mind, Yaha Antya Praptaha Artha Na Tatra Vakyasya Abhiprayaha. Here there is a discontinuation. Looks like there is a discontinuation. Is a page missing? 346. Okay, so it's a statement which says Yaha Anyata Praptaha Artha न तत्र वाक्यस्य अभिप्राय अन्यथा अन्यथा प्राप्त व्हाट इज अन्यथा प्राप्त ऑन दैट देयर इज अ टिप्पणा सो अगेन आई डोंट वांट टू गो थ्रू दिस देयर आर मेनी स्टेटमेंट्स व्हिच लुक लाइक विधि एज टू व्हाट अ गृहस्थ शुड डू एज अ कपल व्हाट शुड वन डू देन व्हाट काइंड ऑफ फूड शुड वन हैव एंड देयर इज मेंशन ऑफ लिकर आल्सो एट टाइम्स पीपल विल रीड इट एज liquor because suragraham grinnati sautravanyam so all these are there parinitam upagachhet rutau bharyam upeyat hutashesham bhakshayet sautramanyam suragraham grinnati now these vakyas are all we have to see in the context of the vedas where they occur but then if you take it as a vidhi then it appears as though you know, some people would say there is surapana. They'll say mausa bhakshana is there. Then they say you have to indulge with your partner physically. All these ideas would be there, but then that is a wrong interpretation. It is a nisheda mukha shastra. It is not vidhi mukha at all. So what it says is that instead of doing what is swabhavika to the animal tendencies instinctually being there in a human being also, you avoid those and do this. So not do this, you avoid those. And if one understands that, then one wouldn't do this Vedika karma also where these are talked about. If you know it is Nisheda Mukha, then you will avoid it. For example, if someone tells you, Dharma Shastra says that on Ekadashi, do not eat these kind of food. Why? Because you are supposed to do a lot of dharmika karya on that day. What does it really tell you? If you inquire on it, whatever you are shunning, there may be some particular things which you avoid for a different reason. But there are some things which you should necessarily avoid on all days. Definitely not on Ekadashi, should you have such kind of food? What does that mean? Those things you should never have. At least on that day you don't have it means on other days also you do not have. That is the real understanding in Ekadashi Upavasa also related to food. Although Upavasa has a different meaning. I'm sure you all know that. So Nishidha Vakya. These are all Nisheda Pradhana. For a person who is in the right frame of mind and can inquire, one knows that if it is said that I should not have it on a particular day so that I can focus towards the end goal of all life, then why should I have it on other days? Similarly here, if something has been said you do this only during this time or you do this during this time, means that you do not do it other times. What does it mean? You do not do it at that time also. Better to avoid it. That is the final aim of such vakyas also. So ityadi vidhi vakyana, they are seen as vidhi vakyas. Ragata svatav prapte swastri sange sada bharya sangame sada madhumamsadi bhakshaneva pravartane naiva tatparyam. It is not saying that you have, you know, mamsa madira ityadi or stri sanga bharya sangame ityadi. Do not, there is no vidhi there at all. किंतु स्वभाव सिद्ध सर्वतो मुख स्वेच्छा प्रवृत्ति संकोच द्वारा निवृत्तव परम तात्पर्यम् इट सेज यू डू नॉट डू इट एट अदर टाइम्स एंड देन इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड इट यू डू नॉट डू इट एवर वंस यू अंडरस्टैंड इट यू ड्रॉप ऑल ऑफ दैट एंड टेक टू ब्रह्म ज्ञान दैट इज द तात्पर्य तस्मात् तादृश वेद वाक्यानि परिसंख्या विधि स्वरूपाणि भवन्ति न तु अपूर्व विधि रूपाणि सो पूर्व मीमांसकास एनालाइज द कर्मास बाय पुटिंग देम इनटू कैटेगरी व्हिच कैटेगरी डज दिस कर्म फॉल इन इज इट अ विधि प्रधान इज इट अ अपूर्व विधि मींस व्हिच इज अननोन यू डोंट नो अदर देन वेदास टेलिंग यू यू डू दिस और सच अ थिंग एग्जिस्ट देयर इज स्वर्ग यू नो ओनली थ्रू वेदास हाउ डू यू हैव स्वर्ग प्राप्ति साधना इज ऑल्सो रिवील्ड बाय द सेम शास्त्र which also reveals tattvamasi which you wouldn't know otherwise by any other means so that is apurva vidhi which something which you don't know so karma kanda jnana kanda also talks about something now they they call it arthavada also, some are arthavadas, but there are some which are called as parisankhya vidhi. They are not apurva vidhi, they are parisankhya vidhi. What are parisankhya vidhi? They are nisheda pradana. Nava niyama vidhi rupani. So there is no niyama vidhi, there is no apurva vidhi, there is no, it is parisankhya vidhi, it is not arthavada also. So shena yaga bodhaka atharva veda vachananamapi dveshata prapta shatru marana pravartare na tatparyam kintu tadrusha swabhava siddha pravritti nirodhana dvara tadrusha vishadana adi krura karma nivartane eva tatparyam. Even when the shruti says you do shena yaga, what it means is that you do not do any other krura karma to take care of the enemy. This we saw in the Moola itself. Tasmat shena yaga bodhaka vachanamapi parisankhya parisankhyatmakam eva iti kathyate. So therefore shena yaga is also what? It is parisankhya vidhi, meaning it is not a vidhi at all, it is nisheda pradana. Tatacha bhagavate, and bhagavata also says that loke vyavaya misha madhya seva nityastu jantur nahi tatra chodana vyavasthitistasu vivaha yajna suragrahai rasu nivrittirishta iti. Nivrittirishta, finally. There are so many things talked about here, the same things which we have seen it, I don't want to repeat it. So vivaha yajna suragraha, all that mentioned, when you partake of all that is swabhava prapta, swabhavata prapta, what is being done is that it is training you to slowly withdraw, and then finally nivrittir ishta. Iti ragata dveshato va prapta pravritti sankocha bodhaka veda vachanam parisankhya rupam ityuchyate. So we know what is parisankhya now. These are all like that, they are parisankhya or nisheda pradhana. This is extended to other things also. So ittham atharva veda samanyam nivrittaveva tatparyavat. So atharva veda samanyata, if you look at it, what is it? Is it is nivruttaveva tatparyavat. It has tatparya only in nivritti. Itara veda trayagata karma bodhaka vakyanam antakarana shuddhi dvara jnana upayogitvam patisputam. So if you just look at atharva veda itself and one shena yaga, it is parisankhya vidhi, meaning nisheda pradhana. So it is extended to the entire atharva veda. What about the other three Vedas? They lead to chitta shuddhi. Therefore, all the karmas are across the three Vedas are focused towards chitta shuddhi. Therefore, antakrana shuddhi dvara kramena jnana upayogitvam is there. So, jnana upayogitvam atisputam. It is very clear because we are almost at the end of the grantha. We know all this. What about upavedas now? Upavedanam api chaturnam kramad brahmajnane eva tatparyam. Ayurveda, Dhanurveda, Gandharvaveda, Arthaveda iti upavedas chatvaraha. There are these four Vedas. I'll just go through this section. What we get, what we get. There is not much importance here except for seeing how they are useful towards jnana, how that is the tatparya. So there are discussions of, you know, what all this contains, but we'll go to the tatparya vishaya there as to how these are useful towards jnana. So Ayurveda is upaveda. Ayurvedasya kartara brahma prajapati ashwini kumaro dhanvantari adeshcha. So there are so many who have authored or derived these works from Vedas called Ayurveda. Therefore it is an upaveda. Tatshastrani charaka vagbhattadi chikitsa granthascha ayurveda eva. Based on that, there are other charaka ityadi. These are also ayurveda. Vatsayana krita kama shastram api ayurveda antargatam eva. So this Vatsayana, interestingly, Vatsayana was a brahmachari, and he came up this work, famous worldwide, especially among westerners, kama sutra. So kama, it is called as kama shastra here. That is also what? Ayurveda antargata eva. It is इंक्लूडेड इन आयुर्वेद कामशास्त्र से विषयभूतम वाजीकरण स्तंभनादिकम अपि चरकादिभिरुक्तम सो चरका इन आयुर्वेद ही टॉक्स अबाउट दिस आल्सो देयरफॉर इट इज नोन दैट इट इज इंक्लूडेड इन आयुर्वेद आयुर्वेदस्यापि वैराग्य प्रतिपादनेव तात्पर्यम व्हाट इज दिस कामसूत्र आल्सो डूइंग इट इज आल्सो वैराग्य प्रधान रियली देयर इज नो सुखा इन इट इट इज ऑल विषय सुखा वेयर देयर इज नो विषय सुख एट ऑल सो प्रथम मल्ल न्याय वॉट एवर इज दी मोस्ट डिजायरेबल इंस्टिंक्टिवली इन दैट ऑल्सो देर इज नो सुख सो प्रथम मल्ल न्याय नित्य सुख इज नॉट देर इन एनी विषय सो एंटायर आयुर्वेद इज ऑल्सो वैराग्य प्रधान हाउ सो आयुर्वेद इज ट्राइंग टू फिक्स युअर डिसीजेस whenever we are not at ease we need medication so that tells us that for sukha where is my sukha is in my swarupa whenever I am outside my swarupa I have dukkha so I am trying to go back from my discomfort disease to ease so swasthyam is what swasmin tishtati iti swasthyam स्वस्मिन् तिष्ठति इति स्वस्थ तस्य भाव स्वास्थ्यम् व्हाट इज स्वास्थ्यम् बीइंग स्वस्थ इज स्वास्थ्यम् व्हाट इज बीइंग स्वस्थ समास इज उपपद तत्पुरुष स्वस्मिन् तिष्ठति इति स्वस्मिन् स्वरूपे स्वस्वरूपे तिष्ठति इति स्वस्थ तस्य भाव स्वास्थ्यम् सो आयुर्वेद टेल्स यू यू शुड हैव स्वास्थ्य meaning you should be in your own swarupa how by fixing all other problems taking away discomfort you will find discomfort in everything unless you are in your own swarupa so ayurvedasya api vairagya pratipadaneva tatparyam ayurveda ritya rogadi nivrutta api puna rogadi sambhavat these diseases come back again and again how much ever you do prarabdha will have an influence तस्माल लौकिक उपायः सर्वे अपि तुच्छैव लौकिक उपाय डोंट टू वर्क यू हैव टू हैव अलौकिक उपाय व्हाट इज दैट विथड्रॉ फ्रॉम ऑल द लौकिक स्टे इन योर ओन स्वरूप तस्माद् औषधा दाना तस्माद् औषध दानादि जनित पुण्याविर्भूत अंतकरण शुद्धि द्वारा ब्रह्मज्ञानेव आयुर्वेदस्य उपयोगः व्हाट इज द उपयोग तात्पर्य विषय इज ओनली ब्रह्मज्ञान इवन इन आयुर्वेद आयुर्वेद इन द एंड इट विल से दैट द फाइनल गोल इज मोक्ष व्हिच इज द डिसीज संसार इज अ डिसीज टेकिंग दिस बॉडी फर्स्ट यू फिक्स बॉडीली एंड मेंटल प्रॉब्लम्स देन यू सी दिस दिस बॉडी इटसेल्फ इज अ रोग सो हाउ डू यू फिक्स दैट फाइनल रोग भव रोग बाय टेकिंग केयर ऑफ दिस जन्म इट्सेल्फ जन्म मरण साइकिल संसार बाय ज्ञान थ्रू ज्ञान धनुर्वेद व्हाट अबाउट धनुर्वेद हाउ कैन धनुर्वेद हैव तात्पर्य इन ब्रह्मज्ञान सो दिस इज आल्सो इंक्वायर्ड बाय तर्क दृष्टि विश्वामित्र कृते धनुर्वेदे आयुधम निरूपितम तच्च चतुर्विधम सो तच्च चतुर्विधम सो देयर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ आयुधास वेपन्स धनुर्वेद इज शास्त्र व्हिच डील्स विद वेपन्स Vishwamitra came up with this. What are those? Muktam, amuktam, mukta muktam, yantra muktam cheti. So category of weapons, and they are further described. Chakradaya hastena muchyamanatvat mukta ityuchyante. Muktas are those weapons which, like chakra etc., Sudarshan chakra ityadi, which are freed from the hand. So they are thrown from the hand. Therefore, they are called as mukta. Khadgadaya amukta iti. So you don't free the sword from your hand you usually you would throw a sword at someone as a warrior so you hold it in your hand therefore they are called as amukta parashvadayah mukta mukta iti an axe parashurama used this axe he was a brahmana who played the role of a kshatriya for a purpose so his weapon of choice was the axe parashu his name parashurama itself is from the axe he is rama but who has a parshu. Therefore, Parshurama. This parshu, the axe, can be held in the hand as a battle weapon, or it can be thrown also. Therefore, it is mukta mukta. Sharagola kadayaha yantra mukta iti. Then there are, you know, these missiles. So they, missiles, or you know, you throw stones there. You launch stones or launch weapons, so those are through some other machinery, therefore they are called as yantra mukta. So anyway, we have no interest in that per se. Mukta muktam astram ityuchyate amuktam shastram iti chaturvidhanam api etesham ayudhanam brahma vishnu pashupati prajapati agnihi varuna ityadaya devataha tattan mantras choktaha. Then there are mantras. You know, these devatas are also there. Then mantras related to those weapons are also there. These muktas are called as astra, amuktas are called as shastra. So there is a technical name given to the category of the weapon also. They have their own devatas, they have their own mantras also. Tatra cha adhikarinaha kshatriya kumaraha tadanurvartinaha brahmanadayascha. So who is the adhikari in this Dhanurveda Shastra really? To understand maybe everyone, but understanding is not sufficient. These are all kind of karma kanda, you have to use them. So there adhikaris are kshatriyas, kings, and tat kumaraha. Kshatriya kumaras, basically the prince who or children of kshatriyas, comes from the kshatriya in the highest place is a king, the raja. Then tadanuvartinaha brahmanadayascha. So others are also eligible who have such kind of pravritti, who find themselves in that place. For example, Kripacharya, Dronacharya, these were brahmanas who were not only teachers but they also fought the battle. Techa chaturvidaha padatihi ratharudaha ashwarudaha gajarudascheti. So who are these warriors? They are also categorized based on the vehicle as well. So whether they ride an elephant, a horse, chariot, or whether they are on foot. Yudhe shakuna mangaladikam api uktam eva. So there are other omens also which are talked about anyway. ईदृशार्थः धनुर्वेदस्य प्रथमपादे कथितः आचार्यलक्षणं ततः शास्त्राभ्यासक्रमादिकं च द्वितीयपादे गुरुसम्प्रदायप्राप्तस्य शस्त्रस्य अभ्यासमन्त्रसिद्धिदेवतासिद्धिप्रकारस्य तृतीयपादे सिद्धानां मन्त्रादीनां प्रयोगादिकं चतुर्थपादे. सो देर् आर् फोर् चाप्टर्स् देर् आल्सो सेक्षन्स् इन् धनुर्वेद आल्सो. इन् दि फस्ट् देर् इस् दि ऐडिया विच् हेस् बिन् डिस्क्रैब्ड् जस्ट् नौ कम्स् अप् इन् दि फस्ट् चाप्टर्. Then what is the Acharya Lakshana? How the Acharya should be, that is discussed in the second chapter, and the sequence of study is also mentioned there in the second chapter. The third chapter talks about the Shastras, the Abhyasa, the Mantra, how to use the Shastras, how to use the Mantras, how to have the Mantra Siddhi, Devata Siddhi, etc. for those weapons. As received from the Guru Sampradaya. The fourth chapter is after this Mantra Siddhi. How do you use the Mantra after the Mantra Siddhi? Mantra Siddhi should be first. You cannot just utter the Mantra and use it. There should be Mantra Siddhi. So the Mantra Siddhi Krama is all given in the third chapter and how to put it to use in the fourth chapter. What does it have to do with Brahma Jnana Dhu? So this question lingers on. Ayancha Dhanurveda Brahma Prajapatibhyam Vishwamitrena Praptaha. Vishwamitra got it from Brahma, Prajapati, etc. Chaturmukha Brahma, such a Jagat Prasiddham Imam Akarot. So he made it famous. Further, having received it, he didn't keep it to himself. He gave it to others. Nata, natu, Vishwamitra evayam vedo abhut. He didn't create it. He brought it in the Sampradaya. He is a link there. Dhanurvedo hi dushta choradibhya prajapalana rupam kshatriya dharmam bodayati. It is not that you have this Mantra Siddhi or you have weapons and you just go around and do whatever you like. The usefulness of the Dhanurveda is for what? The purpose is to protect yourself and your Praja from Dushta Choradibhya. So from Dushta Choradi. from thieves and other miscreants you have to protect your praja, therefore dhanur veda is taught to them. This is kshatriya dharma. Tasma tasyapi chitta shuddhi dwara jnana sadhya moksha pratipadaneva tatparyam. Arjuna was said you follow your kshatriya dharma. Why? Swarga prapti is through that. So it's a win-win situation. You have a war available whereby if you die in the war, you will get swarga. If you do not die in the war, you will get pleasure here and now, palatial mansions, etc. But that is not the tatpare vishya. Why is Bhagavan Krishna telling him? First he says you do this. He is not interested in any of that because he is shoka grasta, moha grasta. Arjuna Vishada Yoga. That's why the first chapter is called as Arjuna Vishada Yoga. The topic is Arjuna's Vishada grief. In that grief, you tell him where he is saying that I don't want any of this riches. I don't want Swarga also. This is all Papa Karma. How can I kill my own bandhus, my gurus? There, if Bhagavan Krishna tells him, no, you will get this Swarga, he does not want Swarga. So what? Why is he saying that? Even with that in mind, you do it because it is your dharma. You will get chitta shuddhi. Then he sees there is an eligibility and teaches him Brahma Jnana. So karma yoga is what? Following your own swadharma, varnashrama prapta. Kshatriya should be fighting a battle to protect others. Thereby his chitta shuddhi. Not by doing brahmana karma or vaishya karma or shudra karma. Similarly, Brahmana also. But it is not limited only to a Brahmana. Each has his own role to play. So if a Brahmana starts doing business and says that in business I'll earn Chitta Shuddhi, he will not earn Chitta Shuddhi, he'll earn money. He will also be drawn away from Chitta Shuddhi because if he has given up his own Swakarma. And mostly one will be compromising Swashrama Karma if one is doing something else. Which you have seen earlier. Pratyavaya dosha is that you will be doing something you are not supposed to do. Thereby, chitta shuddhi is not easy there. Now, Shudra who says that I will do Vedanta patha will not get chitta shuddhi. He may get papa. Why? Because it is nishiddha. Why it is nishiddha? Because he has not earned it in his earlier janma. What has he earned? He has earned simple way to moksha also. Why? He does not have to do complicated mantras, he does not have to spend his entire life in that and live on whatever dakshina comes up across. He can earn his livelihood by doing all sorts of services. And his moksha is possible, his chitta shuddhi is possible by serving others. And his moksha is possible through Purana Kathas, etc. He does not have to do a lot. It is possible. Difficult but possible, but then difficult in the sense because he chitta shuddhi is difficult because the pravritti, the mind is tainted in a particular manner. But there is an exception. It is true with Brahmanas also. Today Kali Yuga Brahmanas have the antakarana as ashuddha as a shudra. There is no difference there. But there is a possibility because one earned it. So there is a possibility if at all one was a Kalyanakrut in earlier janma. In any Varnashrama, if he is there, depending on the degree of Kalyana Kritta, one will continue the journey. This is the Ashwasana given by Bhagavan Krishna himself. Thereby, the journey would continue in that very role that you are playing. If one is jumping across, then one is neither here nor there. Similarly, the Vaishya can do business and earn money and help others get what they want, thereby his chitta shuddhi is through that varnashrama prapta karma. So for everyone moksha is possible through their own karma. Swakarmana tamabhyarcha siddhim vindati manava, says Bhagavan Krishna. Using your own karma, that itself is chitta shuddhi marga, and through chitta shuddhi one gets siddhi, which is what? Purushartha, parama purushartha moksha. Because that karma, swakarma itself is archana of the Lord. It's the worship of the Lord. Anyway, that's an aside just to mention that all karmas have tatparya only in Brahma Jnana in the end. क्रमेण बी सो हियर धनुर्वेद इज ऑल्सो लाइक दैट बिकॉज इट लीड्स टू चित्त शुद्धि फॉर दोज हु आर एलिजिबल इन यूजिंग धनुर्वेद फॉर देम देयर चित्त शुद्धि इज थ्रू देयर ओन कर्म यूजिंग धनुर्वेद प्राप्त ज्ञान फॉर कर्म एंड थ्रू दैट कर्म वन विल गेट चित्त शुद्धि गंधर्व वेद व्हाट इज गंधर्व वेद अयम च भरतेन मुनिना लोके प्रसिद्ध अभूत सो भरत मुनि मेड इट फेमस इन द वर्ल्ड तत्र ही स्वरताल मूर्छनादि सह गीत नृत्यवाद्यादिकं सविस्तरं निरूपितं सो इट इज बेसिकली सोर्स ऑफ ऑल म्यूजिक एंड डांस आर्ट फॉर्म्स हाउ डज इट रिलेट टू ब्रह्मज्ञान देवताराधन निर्विकल्पक समाधि सिद्धि गांधर्व वेदस्य प्रयोजनम् उच्यते गांधर्व वेद सो यू हैव हियर ऑफ हा हा हू हू व्हाटएवर दिस गंधर्वस इन लघु सिद्धांत कौमुदी देयर विल बी ऊकारांत पुल्लिंग अनहर्ड ऑफ एल्सवेयर इन गंधर्वस यू विल फाइंड सच नेम्स सो दिस गंधर्वस हैव दिस नॉलेज हैव दिस knowledge units so whatever these are music and art forms they lead to so we have this you know brahmanada people talk about brahmanada shabda brahma all these will lead to samadhi and thereby it can lead to moksha through brahmajnana they will facilitate brahmajnana and thereby moksha That is mentioned here. Devata Aradhana Nirvikalpaka Samadhi. So Devata Aradhana is through shlokas, dutis. There will hardly be anyone who does not like some kind of singing, some kind of music. Be it any kind. But then if it is focused towards Devata Aradhana, then it has served its purpose and that is the final goal also of that Shastra Gandharva Veda. तस्मात् तस्यापि अंतःकरण एकाग्रता संपादनेन ज्ञान द्वारा मोक्षे एव परमं प्रयोजनम् अर्थवेद सो अर्थवेद अर्थवेदोपि नाना प्रकार देयर आर मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ अर्थवेद अर्थ इज व्हाट वेल्थ सो व्हाटएवर रिसोर्सेस यू नीड यू कैन गेट बाय अंडरस्टैंडिंग हाउ टू अर्न दोज रिसोर्सेस दीज आर टॉक्ड अबाउट इन अर्थवेद नीति शास्त्रम अश्वशास्त्रम शिल्पशास्त्रम सूपकारशास्त्रम इत्यादिकं धन प्राप्ति उपाय बोधकं अर्थवेद इत्युच्यते सो नीति शास्त्र यू नो पॉलिटिक्स एटसेट्रा शिल्पशास्त्रम यू नो आर्ट ऑफ स्कल्पचर्स एटसेट्रा ऑल दीज आर देयर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स टॉक्ड अबाउट एज हाउ टू अर्न अर्थ दीज टेक्स्ट आर फोकस्ड टुवर्ड्स धन प्राप्ति धन प्राप्ति उपाय निपुणस्यापि विना भाग्यम धन प्राप्ति न स्यात् वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेटमेंट देयर लेट्स से यू हैव ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ स्किल्स यू इन द सेंस एनीवन यू नो ऑफ देयर आर सो मेनी स्किल्स इन अ पर्सन बट देन यू सी द पर्सन इज अनेबल टू मेक मनी व्हाई मे बी द अंतकरण इज नॉट स्टेबल मे बी समथिंग एल्स इज रॉन्ग ऑल यू सी एज प्रारब्ध इज नॉट फेवरिंग For the skills to be linked to the dhana. One has skills but cannot reach the goal, cannot put into practice. Even after putting into practice, one can't make money, get cheated, whatever it is. So, dhana praptir na syat bhagyam vina. Ityatah, arthavedasya api vairagya bodhane eva tatparyam. How much ever you are skilled, there are people who have flocked to engineering colleges. Initially it was, you know, either a doctor or an engineer. Then that fever ended and it became only engineering. Medicine also became too expensive. Colleges became too expensive, too corrupt. Engineering colleges in Bangalore, every two-story building started becoming, I mean, exaggeration, but I know the era where every few stories if you have that kind of an building if you own or you rent out also it is a university not a university per se a college an engineering college so many seats have gone empty so many seats have been paid through bribes bought somehow engineered, and then the person who is an engineer is jobless, starts doing these call center jobs. I mean, look at it, so many engineers, but no engineering really. Why? It is, there's no talent really. They just, there's a value in certification. Even if there is skill, just because he comes from this college or whatever, there is no job. So there are many, many an engineer who are jobless. Skilled or unskilled, you can't really call them unskilled because there is a certificate to dangle around. What happens is that finally these should be vairagya karaka. Whatever you do, finally the end goal is not what you are looking for, because you are not getting that also. What is the end goal? Sukha. That sukha is not there anywhere. You do whatever, money has gone, years have gone, and then still no luck favoring. That will come about only in shastra, shastra jnana. Therefore vairagya bodhane eva tatparyam. So there are other names given here. I'll skip the tippana. What about Vedangas? Vedanganam arthenasa prayojanam. Chaturnam api Vedanam shadangani siyuhu. There are six angas of Vedas. What are these angas? So you look at a Purusha also, Veda Purusha. He has angas, six angas. Which are those? Shiksha, Kalpa, Vyakranam, Niruktam, Jyotisham, Chandaha, Pingala, Shastradi, Cheti, Shat, Vedartha, Jnana, Upayogitvad, Vedangani tyuchyante. Because they are useful for Vedas, they are called as subsidiaries of Vedas, Vedangas. Tatra, among these, what are those? Shiksha ityadi. Shiksha, shikshayaha kartaro panini prabhutaya aneke maharshayaha. So paniniya shiksha, shiksha sutras we hear of, we know of these. Veda shabdakshara sthana adi jnanam. Then udotta udottanudatta swarita. So this is udatta, it should be udatta. So udatta, anudatta, swarita. These are the three swara bhedas we know in Paniniya Shastra Vyakrana. So udatta, anudatta, swarita bhedas are swara bhedas. So swara jnanam ityadi shikshaya jayate. Thank you for prompting me. So I was just trying to recall in the flow there. So shikshaya jayate. Shiksha gives you swara jnana. Veda vyakhyana rupa aneke pratishakhyanam pratishakhya namaka ye grantha te api atra shikshayam antarbhavanti. You count those granthas also in shiksha, which are pratishakhyas, rules of how to pronounce something. So brahma pronunciation, this is one of the cases, rare cases, where hakara is followed by something, then they are interchange in pronunciation. Actually it is a spoken shastra, spoken language. So it is not the way it is written you read, but you write the way it is spoken. So we have it other way around. Generally people say, you know, do you read it the way it is written? That may be true in other languages. You have silent letters and all that. The alphabet is different and the pronunciation in the word is different. Pronunciation across words is also different of a particular letter. So in alphabet you say A, B, but you don't pronounce B when you see Bakara. So when you say Bengaluru, you don't say B, Bengaluru. So you don't say that. The alphabet is pronounced differently. The letter is pronounced differently in an alphabet. It is pronounced differently in a word. And the same C is pronounced differently in the alphabet. It is pronounced across words also different. Sometimes it will have the sound of S, sometimes it will have the sound of K, which is not there in Sanskrita. But the Sanskrita vakyas are written in any language, Devanagari lipi being one, which is the primary lipi there, and thereby called as Sanskrita letter. It is written the way it is pronounced. We don't have it the other way around at all. Only place there is a difference is when hakara is followed by some letters where there is difficulty in pronouncing. Therefore, I'm just giving a reason. Reason may or may not be there, but then you pronounce Brahma not as Brah Brahma, but Brahma. All that is in Pratishakya, how to chant it. So something which is chanted in Vedas is chanted only that way. You don't have Adhikara to chant it any which way. How do you know? It is revealed in that particular Shaka teacher's work, which is called as Pratishakya. These are also in Shiksha, because Shiksha gives you the reason I'm saying Shiksha is because, you know, the Shiksha Valli in Taittiriya has the pronunciation Shiksha. Shiksham Vyakhyasyamaha. So that Shiksha is Dirgha, that is Vaidika Prayoga, Chandasa Prayoga. So that has stuck in. Anyway, the word is Shiksha. This Shiksha Grantha has, Shiksha also means teaching. So teaching of what? The letters. How the letters should be pronounced, where is the sthana, prayatna, so sthana, prayatna, ityadi, all these are revealed in Shiksha. And in particular cases, you should follow Pratishakya. Pratishakya in each Pratishakha. Shakham, Shakham, Prati is Pratishakha, and the work related to the Pratishakya. That is also included in Shiksha Grantha. Kalpasutram. Kalpasutrair Vedabodhita Karmanam Anushthana Ritihi Upadishyate. So how to apply this Veda? So Kalpasutrair Vedabodhita Karma, the karma which is revealed by Vedas, not known elsewhere, how should it be practiced? What is the methodology? Stepwise, all this is seen in Kalpasutra. Yajna karma nivartaka brahmana ritvijaha uchyante tesham pratak pratak kartavya karma krama avabodakam kalpasutram. So the ritvij, what should a ritvij who follows Rigveda, comes from the Rigveda sampradaya, his shaka is Rigvedya shaka. So pratak pratak tesham pratak pratak kartavya karma krama avabodakam kalpasutram. Kalpasutra kartarastu katyayana ashwalayana आदेह मुनय कल्पसूत्रम अपि वेदार्थ ज्ञान उपयोगित्वात् वेदांगम एव. इट टेल्स यू द उपयोग ऑफ द वेद एंड देयर बाय फैसिलिटेट चित्त शुद्धि. देयरफॉर दीज आर ऑल, यू नो, वेदर दे आर कल्पसूत्र कर्ता, हु मेड दिस, कात्यायन अश्वालयन, दीज आर द ऋषिज हु मेड कल्पसूत्रस, हाउ टू पुट द वेद मंत्र रिचुअल्स इनटू प्रैक्टिस, व्हाट इज द एग्जैक्ट वे टू do a particular karma. Vyakaranam, we know this. Vyakranena api veda shabdanam shuddhata jnanam jayate tachya vyakranam sutra rupam ashtadhyayatmakam panini munina virachitam. So Panini Maharshi made these ashtadhyayi sutras. Tat sutranam vyakhyanam vartika rupam bhashya rupam cha katyana patanjali bhyam akari. And then bhashya and vartika. Vartika on that was by katyana muni, and then Bhashya, Mahabhashya by Patanjali. Vyakranantare tu Vaidika Shabda Vicharo Nasti. In other systems of Vyakrana, there were 9 Vyakranas. However, this Panini Vyakrana which survived, in fact, Bhagavan Hanuman, Anjaneya, is said to be Nava Vyakrana Pandita. He is said to be because he is still there. So, in other Vyakranas, there is no Vaidika Shabda analysis, but Panini Vyakrana does Vaidika Shabda analysis also. Tad upyoga Purana adau eva. Other Vyakranas are applicable in understanding Puranas, but Panini Vyakrana helps you understand Vedas and non-Vedas also. Natu Vede Paniniyam eva Vyakrana Vaidika Shabda Swarupa Siddhim Pradarshayati. Therefore, Vyakrana is also an Anga, Veda Upayogitvat, and thereby sadhana of for jnana. Tasmad Vedangam etat, being Vedanga, it is also Vedantanga Kramena. Niruktam Yaskanama Munihi Trayodasha Dhyayatmakam Niruktam Prachayamasa. Nirukta is by Yaska. Yaska Muni has 13 chapters. Tatracha Veda Mantra Gatanam Aprasiddhanam Padanam Arthabodhanaya Nama Nirupanam Kritam. Tasmad Vaidika Aprasiddha Padartha Jnanopayagatvat Niruktam Api Vedangam Eva. It deals with words which are unknown elsewhere, rarely found in some sections of Vedas. You cannot understand the meaning even by Vyakrana. There Nirukta helps out how to understand it is basically the etymology. How does this word come into play? What is the meaning? So lot of such words exist. Rare words, these are dealt with Nirukta. Sanyabodhaka panchadhyayatmako Nigunda nama grantho yaskena akari soopi niruktantargata eva. So there is a Nigunda also. Nigunda is also considered as is created by Yaska Muni, and it is also considered as part of Nirukta. I'll just finish this this section, although we are running a little late. Jyotisham Aditya Gargari Kritam Jyotisham api Vedangam eva. Jyotisha, the astronomy, today astrology as well. What is that? It is basically dealing with Kala, really. Kala, Nakshatra, and in this Kala, what all is taking place? That is the real focus there. So, Aditya Gargari Kritam Jyotisham Ivi Vedangam Eva Vaidika Karmarambhe Kala Jnanasya Apekshitatvat. When should you do a particular Kala? How do you know the Kala? When a particular thing is happening in the sky, you know a particular Kala. When the time is auspicious, when it isn't. All these ideas can be known through Jyotisha. When a particular karma has to be done, can be known only through Jyotisha again. That karma, when it has to be done, may be known through Kalpa Sutra. But when is that when? How do you know that Kala? That is known through Jyotisha. Tadrusha Kala Jnana Janakam Jyotisham Api Vedangam. It helps you understand Kala, which is very difficult to understand, through segmenting that which cannot be segmented. You see in Nyaya, as to Kala is Eka. With Upadhi, with segmentations, you name it and give. You make slots and you have minute details and huge, you know, year-long, decade-long, yuga-long kind of divisions. But then, that is all Nama Bheda. There is no real Bheda in Kala. Chanda, and scientists have also troubled with space and time. Chanda, what is Chanda? The last Anga there is Pingala Munina Ashtadhyaya Parimitam Sutratmakam Chandaha Shastram Nirmitam. So the, what, you know, prosody or meters. Tena Vaidikasya Gayatradish Chandaso Vijnanam Jayate Tasmat Pingala Sutra Api Vedangam Eva. You cannot chant mantra any which way, shlokas also any which way you try to fit in, but then shlokas it's okay, in Vedas it is not okay. Uccharana should be exact, otherwise it can have a reverse meaning, a different meaning. One can get papa. Result can be absolutely shocking, unrelated also. And similarly with chandas also, you have to use the same chanda. That chanda jnana is through chanda shastra, therefore Vedanga, and being Vedanga also, jnana sadhana. Tasmat pingala sutra Vedanga me itham. Shadimani Vedangani Yadyapi Tatra Vedanupayukta Apyarthaha Nirupitaha Tathapi Prasangikatva Tesham Nati Pradana Bhutaha. Although they talk about Vedas, how they connect to Vedas has been shown. Although that is what is discussed, but prasangikatvat, in contextually, what is it really? It is helping you understand Vedas, which are for Chitta Shuddhi. Therefore, they are also Kramena for Chitta Shuddhi, and thereby Kramena Jnanutpatti Sadhana. Focus is not really staying there. Through that, you have to reach further. So, Vyakranam Mukham Smritam. Vedanam Vedasiva Mukham Smritam. Veda Purushasiva. So thereby you understand through Vyakrana what is being said, but you don't stay there. You go to the Tatparya Vishaya. Pradhana Bhutasya Vedasya Yat Prayojanam Tadeva Shannam Api Anganam Natu Prithak. Mimamsaka knows this as to, if there are n number of subsidiary karmas to a main karma, then they are all angas. What are their phalas? They are not discussed separately. There may be some phala for some anga, but the mukhya phala is the phala of the main karma. Similarly here, Veda phala is Chitta Shuddhi. And Chitta Shuddhi dvara Jnane Tatparyam, Mokshe Tatparyam, Brahma Jnane. Therefore, Vedanga's Tatparya is also same Tatparya of Vedas, meaning Chitta Shuddhi and Kramena, Jnana Sadhana. Thereby, Tarka Drishti resolved all this. He is going to inquire into other things also, meaning he is already inquired into, and the sadhu reveals what his understanding is about Ashtadasha Purana Upapurana also. We'll see it in the next part. So Karnityam Swaprakasham Vyapakam Namrupe Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddher Dirkyatva Nirmana Param Sarva Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Paramah Tadeva Annamatto Niti Me Nishchitamatihi. Om Tat Sat. Namaste.
Namaste. Hari Om.